When you talk about businesses, of course you can talk in terms of their own interests. But it's more than that. It has to do with the future of our planet. It has to do with quality of life of people. And it has to do with doing business in the long run. And what we see today is that businesses feel responsible for what's happening. And I must say I'm very enthusiastic about the fact that strategies are changing. When we talk about corporate responsibility, sustainability issues, it has to do with your key performance indicators, with the way you are producing, the way you treat clients, the way you take up societal engagement activities. That is on the agenda of companies. So what you can see today is clear involvement with global issues, and it's necessary for companies that they take up their responsibility, and I think you can see that with many companies. Biodiversity has to do indeed with quality of life in the longer run, and we really can be concerned about what happened to the Earth. It is about our planet. And what you can see now, and I'm very happy with activities like we've seen today, this conference, that people are saying we have to stop this development. We have to do our utmost to change things. So therefore, biodiversity is a very important issue. I think the last decades we've spoken about the results of the Club of Rome report. You're talking about sustainability issues. And today's message was very clear. It's also very important to talk about biodiversity. Because if we would not tackle this issue, you can see what will happen in the future. It's a risk for human life in the long run. And we have to stop the risks we can see today. When we are talking about companies, I think it should start with their responsibilities. Because if companies are willing to do the right things, I think that's really favorable. It has to do with convictions, with a feeling that you are responsible for developments worldwide, that we cannot wait. So, as far as I can see, it has to start with the responsibility of companies themselves. Having said that, of course, governments can facilitate developments. Governments can take into account issues like what's the level playing field, how can governments work together to have the right atmosphere for companies to act. You can take also fiscal measures, tax measures, but I think it should start with the role of the companies themselves. What we see in the Western world is that a lot of governments do have enormous problems, financial problems. So I think that the best things governments can do is concern themselves as partner of a network of relations. And I'm convinced that if the different actors are working together, governments, private sector, NGOs, businesses, I think that's the best guarantee to reach those goals. So therefore, talking about rough governments, I think that also should be a result of a good dialogue between governments, businesses, NGOs. I think that's necessary today. The role of academia is very important, because if you are talking about these developments, you must analyze things, you must see things in a broader perspective, you must see the connections between different developments, and therefore the role of academic people is so enormous important. I'm working at the Erasmus University, so you can imagine I'm always interested in the message of professors, students and so on. That's also the reason why I like to give speech and lectures to students, just to have an interaction with them. For me, universities are really necessary, because companies do have their own responsibility, but also you must have a reflection, you must have countervailing powers, and also creativity. So the best thing to do is that you have the right connection between universities, private sector and governments. Let me give an example, University of Wageningen. Everybody knows that the productivity in the agriculture sector is the highest in the Netherlands compared to other countries. That has to do with generation of new ideas, transfer of knowledge, the organization of the whole knowledge chain. It's a beautiful example how a university can act. So also when we talk about these issues around corporate responsibility, sustainability and so on, we need universities, but also let universities be partner of this type of networks. In the coming decades, it will be necessary to be very clear about the risks. But some things are really sure at the moment. We will have 9 billion people, there will be scarcity of natural resources. You will see that the consumption patterns will change in countries like India and China. So that means the pressure on our planet will increase. Having made that analysis, the question now is, what can we do about it? How can we produce another way? How can we introduce new sustainable techniques? I think that's the element of working together between companies, universities, governments. That's one. That has to do with an atmosphere of responsibility, the willingness to cooperate. But the other element is, there must be a long-term agenda. It must be clear what should be done. And let me give a very concrete example. If you see the problem of drought of nature in many parts of the world, the question is, do we leave it in the way it's now, or do we do everything to change it, to have the green earth again? And there are possibilities to reach it. For example, we have the Naga Foundation, and they are able to have another situation by digging, just digging. So taking care that if it's raining, then the water can stay there. So then you have techniques to get a situation that we will have a green earth again. Such a foundation cannot act alone. You need each other. So it's a matter of having the right analysis, having the right networks, having a clear agenda, and being focused on reaching the concrete results. And if that would be the case, I think then that can be really hope for the future. I think we have reached a stage at the moment that people really can say it's necessary to change things. We cannot go on. In the 70s, when we talked about the Club of Rome, it has been a time of environment is left and doing business right. Left wing and right wing. But today it has nothing to do with left or right. It has to do what's necessary to do. So when you talk about values of the company, sustainability, long-term focus, I think these are key elements. And there's nothing to do with left wing or right wing. It has to do the things that are necessary. Well, of course, it starts with awareness. Listening to what has been said over here, but also try to draw your own conclusions. That's a matter of, well, realizing what has been said today. That's the first step. The second step is, what can it mean for my own company? How can we change things, but also can we get involved in certain projects? And I really hope that visitors of this conference, when they go back to their offices and their companies, that they also will raise this question, what can we do in a concrete way? I think that's really necessary. And I think that's also what people demand at the moment. Not only nice conferences, not only good stories, but also action.